Hello and welcome back to our Proactive London studio. And I'm joined now by Cormac Byrne, who is the Chief Financial Officer at Centrex Metals. So Cormac, a very good day to you. How are you?
You too, Tom, and thanks for having us.
It's great to have you back on. It's actually you and I's first time of speaking, but Centrex is not a stranger to the platform. But perhaps you can get us back up to speed with the company, Cormac, and tell us a bit about what it is you work on.
Yeah, so Centrex Ltd, our flagship project is the Ardmore Phosphate Rock Mine, just outside Mynarsa in country Queensland. So we were very lucky to commission our mine last June and recommenced commercial mining last April. And our commissioned plant actually hit nameplate capacity. And what it's done since then has actually superseded its expectation. We've got an over-engineered plant that can actually produce up to about 120,000 ton an hour. So we are progressing quite well. We announced to the market our stage 1.5. So effectively what that is we originally did a DFS back in August. We updated the DFS back in August 2021. That actually produces an 800,000 ton of product. So what stage 1.5 is, it captures 625, so 80% of the actual tonnages at only 40% of the cost, the CapEx cost, and that includes a 20% contingency.
Fantastic. So before I move on to ask you about any significant milestones you may have achieved recently, Cormac, I would just like to ask about phosphate. For those people less familiar, what is it used for and just how important is it?
Yeah, so the uniqueness about our grade, we've got one of the highest grades definitely in Australia. So we're the first company in Australia to produce a 35% P2O5 product. What that means is we're able to supply into the single super and triple super phosphate markets. Traditionally, we've got Phosphate Hill, which is owned by IPL, which is just about 100 Ks west of our project. That produces a MAP and DAP project, and their grades normally go between 22 and 24%. So we're an input into fertilizer and the food security of Australia.
Simple as that. So how's business been going over the last few years then?
So as I said, we commissioned our mine last June. We've started shipments in September, late September, and we've progressively ramped up from there. We've gone through our wet season, which we've come out the other end of, and now we're starting to ramp up. We made a significant milestone last month with our first commercial size shipment into the Asian markets via our offtake partner, Samsung C&T. So that was another big milestone for the country, or for the company.
Well understood, Cormac. And I've just got one final question from you. What do you think people can expect from the business during the coming years? What's the vision for the future?
Yeah, so obviously we touched on our debt piece, which we're aiming for later on this year. Obviously, we're going to a due diligence phase with NAIF. That's the Northern Australian Infrastructure Fund. That's a very, very good brand for us to be associated with. It's great to get that backing that we've gone through this due diligence phase. That funding will come from debt for our stage 1.5, and that allows us to ramp up to 625,000 ton annualized from there. So that's the key part for us, and just continue our monthly production.
All right. Well, let me wish you the very best of luck with it, Cormac, and thank you very much indeed for your time today. It's been a pleasure chatting.
Thanks again, Tom, and thanks again for the interest. Cheers.